This is Augustana Sports Scene, a weekly update on Viking athletics at South Dakota's largest private college. Now, let's catch up on the action and excitement of Augustana athletics as we roll our Augustana Sports Update for this week.
Last Saturday afternoon, the Augustana football team lost to Winona State University 73-35 at Kirkaby Over Stadium. The Warriors jumped out to an early 17-0 lead before Grant Gebhardt returned a kickoff 92 yards for a touchdown to bring the Vikings within two scores near the end of the second quarter, but the Warriors took a 38-14 lead into halftime. The Vikings responded and started out the second half with two straight scores, highlighted by a 22-yard touchdown run by DeJean Newell. Winona State answered right back and scored five more times while racking up an NSIC record 781 yards of total offense in the victory. Augustana's Josh Hansen etched his name to the record books with three touchdown passes, becoming the school's all-time leader with 71 career touchdown passes. Hansen finished the game 11 of 22 passing for 122 yards and three touchdowns, and continues to lead the conference now with 30 touchdown passes on the season. DeJean Newell rushed for 100-plus yards for the fifth time this season, picking up 138 yards on 13 carries, scoring one touchdown. Darren Nicholson led the Viking receivers with three catches for 55 yards and a score, while Ben Parsley hauled in three passes for 35 yards and a touchdown. Junior Thomas Banasek led the Viking defense with a career-high 13 tackles. In volleyball, the Augustana Vikings went 1-1 last week, picking up a sweep over the University of Sioux Falls on Thursday night before dropping a three-set match to number one-ranked Southwest Minnesota State University on Saturday. Holly Halfmeyer led the Vikings in a sweep over rival Sioux Falls, finishing with 12 kills while hitting 391 for the match. Senior middle blocker Jordan Potenka smashed 9 kills while Courtney Ister added 6 and led the Vikings with 15 digs in the match. Against top-ranked Southwest Minnesota State on Saturday, Holly Halfmeyer, Taylor Herlichka, and Courtney Ister each finished with 9 kills, while Grace Sanders led the Vikings in the back row with 15 digs. The Augustana men's and women's cross-country teams captured Central Region Championships in Joplin, Missouri last Saturday, with both teams placing their top five runners 12th or higher to win the region championship. This marks the first region title for the women's team and the second for the men. Augustana's men last won the region title in 1991. Travis Beniak was the men's individual champion with a time of 29:57, while Runa Falk won the women's 6,000-meter race with a time of 20:39. Adam Braun finished second with a time of 30:10, while Paul Yack delivered a seventh-place finish, crossing the line in 30 minutes and 33 seconds. On the women's side, Leah Black finished second overall with a time of 20 minutes, 49 seconds, followed by Kristen Bronbo, who finished fifth, and Kyle Blakesley, who finished 10th. The Vikings will compete at the national meet on November 17th in Joplin, Missouri. This has been your Augustana Sports Update. We'll be right back with head football coach Mike Aldrich.
Augustana Sports Scene is brought to you by Sanford Health, improving the human condition, and by Mid-Continent Communications, part of our community, part of your life. Augustana Sports Scene is also brought to you by Graham Automotive, real service, real value.
He's got the strength and is making it look easy.
Show renewed strength. Whether it's our physicians, therapists, or athletic trainers, Sanford offers the finest and most integrated orthopedic team and services around.
There's nothing he couldn't lift right now.
For the everyday competitor in all of us, Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Midconnect Extreme Wideband. Three levels of extremely fast connections with exceptional capacity to choose from. Extreme 1.0, exciting speeds that start out faster than anyone in the region. Extreme 2.0, exhilarating speed for gaming or streaming. Extreme 3.0, extraordinary speed for the whole house. It's among the nation's fastest. Three extreme speeds, only from Midconnect Extreme Wideband.
Build your own bundle and save today. xisnext.com.
We're joined with head football coach Mike Aldrich to talk about the Winona State game last Saturday. Coach, the Vikings lost 73-35. A tough game there on Saturday. What were your thoughts on this week's game?
Well, you know, we felt pretty good going into the game. We thought that we matched up well. We've had a great history against Winona. We thought we could exploit them with our running game. And defensively, we've been pretty stout against the run in the past. Against this running back, so we felt good going into the game. Obviously, the game didn't go the way that we wanted it to. Our offense took a long time to get going. We didn't really get our rhythm going until the third quarter. But once we did, we got ourselves back in the football game. Defensively, we had a real tough day. We couldn't successfully stop their offense. They did a great job of mixing the run and the pass. They gave the ball to Rayon Simmons about 27 times, and three of them were pretty big runs. Other than that, it was just kind of chipping away at you until you make a mistake, which is what we did. All three of his big runs, I think we had four missed tackles on each one of those carries. And so once they start getting you so focused on stopping the run, then the pass game just opens up naturally, and guys aren't doing their jobs because they're focused more on the run instead of just what their roles are. So that type of thing can get out of hand pretty easy. And then, you know, we had those three late turnovers at the end of the third quarter and into the fourth quarter that gave them great field position and allowed them to expand the lead.
Let's talk about some individual accomplishments. Josh Hansen threw three touchdown passes. He's now the all-time leader in career touchdown passes with 71 here at Augustana. Obviously a great season for him. He leads the league with 30 touchdown passes. Talk about what his play means for your team.
Well, obviously the way Josh has been playing at such a high, consistent level, and you know, you kind of go out there and expect great things when he's under center. And you know, the one intangible with Josh that we've said before is that, you know, his play inspires others to play hard, because he gets hit and he gets himself, picks himself back up off the ground, dusts himself off without complaining or pointing fingers, and gets back after it. So hopefully that kind of play will finish here for the last week. But he's been definitely a rock for us back there.
Let's move on to John Newell, 138 yards rushing, eighth touchdown of the season. That's a career high. He's rushed for 100 or more five times a season. 75 yards shy of 1,000 for the season. You can't ask for more out of your running back.
Well, you know, the funny part is Dejon had 138 carries on, or 38 yards on 10 carries. So he averaged over 10 yards a carry. He did phenomenally when he got in there. We knew that he was going to be able to have a good day against them. It was just a matter of getting to that point, and it took us a little while to do that. And we were able to mix in CJ in there to be able to pound the rock a little bit too and run some people over. And when CJ gets onto his game, he's pretty inspirational as well. So that combination back there is dangerous. And this was the first game we got over 100 yards out of Dejon. We didn't win. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of been our focus. If we can get 100 out of him, that's when we've been pretty successful.
Let's talk about special teams now. Grant Gebhardt, 92-yard kickoff return. You talk about momentum. This game had a lot of momentum changes early, and that was another one that sparked your team.
Well, we were down, you know, a couple scores there, and our offense was struggling. And so then Grant gets that one, and we saw, as it was a couple of the kick returns earlier, that we were about one block away from that sucker popping. So when it did, it was like a perfect highlight video on how you teach that kick return that we had, that called play. And he popped it, and as soon as he cleared those two blockers that he had, I mean, he just turned it onto another gear and outran his lead blocker for a little bit until Noah caught back up to him. But, he put one move on their safety valve, and he was gone. So, you know, it's something that we've come to expect out of him. Early, we were really good at kick return, and here as of late, we've kind of struggled, so it was good to get back to that.
Let's move on and talk about the Southwest Minnesota State game to end the season. Another team that kind of provide a rushing attack for you, two running backs that run the ball well, the quarterback can throw, but we should be able to take advantage of some of the things they do on defense as well.
Well, you know, Southwest State is, you know, they're very similar to a lot of us teams here this year that are in the middle of the pack, where one game they don't show up, and which is similar to us, and then the next week they can take somebody out that you would think on paper they don't have a chance to beat. And, you know, you look back, they lost to Crookston early, and they did a great job of bouncing back and fighting everybody. They beat Wayne State. They had a great win against Concordia last week, which I know was very big for them, because Concordia has had their number here for the past few years. So I know that going into this game, they're going to be pretty excited to finish out strong with a win. We're both kind of in that same boat in terms of win-loss, and you know, we've had some successes against him here them in the past, and I know that they'll feel like this is a good opportunity for them to get their chance at beating us, which I would agree with. I mean, I would be in the same mindset that they are as well. But their quarterback's very veteran, Pashong. He's been there, throws the ball very well, makes great decisions. Both those running backs have been phenomenal. I mean, it's a great 1-2 punch, a little bit different than ours, but very effective either way. And they've got a great tight end that they can throw the ball to. And if you've got a tight end that's got high possession ability, it's tough to defend across the field.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck at in Marshall this week, and we'll talk to you next week.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's got that certain everything. The 2012 Jetta, that's the power of German engineering.
You can be part of
something bigger.
As Sioux Empire Federal Credit Union, you'll have more than a place to do your banking.
As a member of Sioux Empire Federal Credit Union, you'll receive interest refunds on your loans, actual cash back every month.
They're the loan leaders. They even gave their members over $91,000 back last year.
And no hoops to jump through.
Just a place to do your banking, where you are the focus, not profit.
Sioux Empire Federal Credit Union. Yesterday's values, tomorrow's technology.
With me now is Augustana volleyball coach Ashley Buckley. The Vikings are coming off a sweep over the University of Sioux Falls last Thursday, and the Vikings traveled to Marshall, Minnesota on Saturday to take on the top-ranked Southwest Minnesota State University Mustangs, where the Vikings fell in three sets. Coach, 1-1 on the weekend, two big matches coming up this week. What were your thoughts on that Sioux Falls match on last Thursday?
I thought we came out really fired up. It was a great home crowd, so that was exciting. Lots of energy, lots of intensity from our girls, and I thought we came out really sharp. We passed the ball well in system. The first 7 points, I thought that they had control of the game, but after that I felt like we adjusted our defense accordingly. Our blocking improved at the net with our sequencing, and I think we were, you know, well matched in the middle position, and Holly Halfmeyer looked like she was finally back and took some really big swings for us.
You talk about that, the start to that match. How did that kind of momentum swing help you guys go on and win that match? I know USF came out pretty strong and pretty excited to play, and you guys took that momentum away, won that first set, and just carried that on to the next two.
Yeah, I mean, it was a little startling in the first 10 points just to see how fired up they were to play. I thought that they took really good swings. They hit angles out of the middle. But again, I thought that we widened our block. Our back row, especially Grace Sanders, adjusted to the middle of the court better. I thought we regained control. But they're a good team. They're really athletic, especially in that outside pin. And so they are, in a sense, a scary team to play in that if you aren't steady at the net, they're a team that can score points just based on their athleticism. So it was good we got a handle on them, and I think after that first 10 points, we were steady throughout and found a way to win all three.
It looked like you guys made some adjustments out there. I noticed Holly Halfmeyer really coming around in that swing and putting the ball down in the middle of the court. Did you get some adjustment you guys made at a timeout, or just something you guys looked to get Holly doing into that match?
Well, we talked about just getting, you know, her on a slide and Taylor the same thing so that we could swing to their one quarter, the right back position. I thought that she did that really well. And again, it's just nice to see her finally attack the ball with a little bit more aggression. I think that she's been a little tentative these last few weeks and trying to keep her hitting percentage up. But she was aggressive, and good things happen. We tell her good things happen when you're swinging hard. So I thought she adjusted, and, you know, it was probably a really good feel-good night for her.
Let's talk about that Southwest Minnesota State match now. You guys went in there, and you hung with them. And, I mean, you were ahead in that first set by 2 points there late, and they ended up coming away with the win in that set. How much of a momentum swing was that for you guys on Saturday?
Unfortunately, I think it was, you know, a huge momentum loss for us. We were at 23-21. Had game point, we got an unfortunate call where they called a touch on our block. I think had we have gotten game point, it maybe would have been a different scenario for us. But nevertheless, we need to focus better between sets one and two. I feel like we should have come out stronger in the second set, having almost won that first one. Instead, we kind of relaxed from the first 10 points, and then we played hard, and then we relaxed again. So what we need to work on in those big matches is playing a consistent set, playing steady, not giving up strings of points. But they're a good team, and there's a reason they're number one in the country. So I wish we would have won the first one. It maybe would have been a different outcome, or we would have at least been happy to push it to four sets versus three. but we're learning, and we know that these are games, again, that we're going to need to be better in, a little bit sharper here in the home stretch.
Move on now this coming weekend, but two big matches on the road, Upper Iowa, Winona State. Two wins would be huge right now, tied for fifth in the conference, ranked 10th in the Central Region rankings. Make a move in this conference tournament, what do we have to do?
We have to play well on our side of the net. I think our wins have come because we've played well. Our losses have come because we haven't played well. And granted, we're always playing a great opponent, but we need to be more steady. This weekend is really important because you could find yourself, if you don't play well, out of the conference tournament since it is so tight, especially in that fifth position. So focus needs to be really good. We'll need to work on our offense defensively. Both teams are coming on hot right now, so we need to be good defensively because both teams are coming on hot on offense. Winona's played a steady year. Upper Iowa's coming on really strong in this last half of the NSIC conference. So we need to be good. We're excited to play, and we're ready.
All right, thanks for joining us, Ashley, and good luck this weekend, and we look forward to getting in that conference tournament and moving on to the postseason.
Thank you.
Thank you.
One, two, three, four.
Today we come together, united as a human family. Today we share the same stage, the same commitment, the same dream. Today is not just about the ceremony, the flags raised at the end. It's about what it takes to get there, the commitment, the finest training, and digging deep when the moment depends on it. Today we come together to improve the human condition.
With 25 years of experience and an outstanding trio of dentists, Drs. Birdall, Fayok, and Swingdorf, along with their caring team at Sensational Smiles, are passionate about developing long-lasting relationships. Sensational Smiles will partner with you to keep your teeth clean for a lifetime. Also check out our cavity-free club for kids with Sammy, our mascot, at SensationalSmilesForYou.com. Call 332-4751 now for a sensational smile every day. Joining me now is outstanding Augustana receiver, senior Ben Parsley. Ben, great to have you on Augustana Sports Scene. Fans, you're used to watching this guy leap up and catch that ball in the end zone, and we're going to talk about that a little bit later. But to begin with, Ben, let's go backwards. Flandreau, South Dakota.
That's right.
And after high school and a great career, you had to make a decision on college. Why'd you choose Augustana?
Well, it was just really, it came down to, I think it was USD, over Augie, and then, or, you know, had to pick between those two, and I don't know, I just, when I came here, I came with my dad, and I remember Brad Salem was recruiting me at the time, and he came all the way to Flandreau, and, you know, took me out of class and had a conversation with me, which I thought was really cool from a head coaching, you know, perspective, and, you know, USC's coach at the time wasn't, you know, a guy like that who would just come and talk to you like that, so I think that was probably the good first impression then came on my visit, and that sealed the deal. And I actually was down here playing in a basketball tournament, and before the game, I just walked into Coach Salem's office. I don't think he even knew that I was there, and I just like, hey, Coach, I decided I'm coming to Augie, and I left.
Yeah, so. Cool. Well, you made a nice night for him. That's great. And you've had a great career here, Ben. Let's talk a little football. Have you always been a receiver?
No, I started out as a quarterback back in middle school, and then I moved to Flandreau as a wing tee, so we don't throw the ball that much, or we didn't until I got up in the ranks there. But mostly I played running back, and then I played receiver quite a bit like my junior year because we had plenty of running backs and we didn't have a lot of receivers, so I just kind of went where I was needed.
And then got to Augie, and you were always a receiver here, right?
Yep.
And then talk about what you, I guess, learned over the years and how, who maybe influenced you and how you're in your skills that you now have. You're having a great year.
I'd say probably the biggest role model for me was Coach Van Dam. He was our coach last year and the year before that. So I was, he taught me most of my, you know, technical things. Mm-hmm. And then other than that, it's just kind of skills I learned growing up through high school and probably goes all the way back to my dad throwing me the ball when I was a kid.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's kind of every kid's dream, I think, to go, you know, into the end zone and have a ball kind of thrown up to him among a crowd and then to jump up and get it. How do you, I mean, you at Concordia last week, I mean, it was fantastic. You've had some other great ones. How do you do it?
I don't know. I think it's more just a reaction. I've said this before, but, you know, with those kind of catches, you don't really try to do that. You just kind of, you just go up and kind of hope for the best, and you just let your body react to the ball. And
yeah,
for some reason, it's working out well for me this year.
So yeah, yeah,
it always has been.
Had a super year. Well, moving over, Ben, into the academic world, your major and future plans.
Well, I'm a biochemistry major. Should graduate in December here. I'm hoping to go to grad school at the U of M. For alternative fuels and try to make some alternative energy jobs that come back to this this neck of the woods, our region, you know, mm-hmm. farming jobs and stuff
right,
like that.
Right.
So that's kind of my goal. From
okay, you're okay, great. You're an old timer here, red shirted, so you're a fifth year senior. Reflect on your days as a student and a football player at Augie.
Well, it's been a great ride, and I've made a lot of great relationships, especially with the guys on the team and, you know, just people in general at Augie, professors and, you know, jobs in the community. Augie's helped me, you know, kind of get a start to my career in that aspect, kind of helped me out. I'm working at Poet now, so
mm-hmm.
Augie's helped me with that. But mostly, yeah, just the relationships and the friends that I've made here have been outstanding, and, you know, they'll be relationships I'll keep for the rest of my life, and I won't ever forget it.
Well, it's been wonderful having you here, Ben, watching you play football, and as a student, obviously an intelligent guy that's going to go a long way. So good luck, Ben.
Thanks, Bill.
Meet Rob Moore from Aberdeen, South Dakota. As a Mid-Continent service manager, he makes sure our service techs have the tools to keep customers ahead of the technology game. Rob also keeps busy coaching youth football, teaching kids both the fundamentals of the game and good sportsmanship. Looks like Rob's a game changer in more ways than one.
I'm Rob Moore, and we're good people here in Aberdeen.
Timing means everything here at Sanford, where experts have the skill to make split-second decisions when life hands you the unexpected. It takes a team to be the best, prepared and connected to a network of care, to life-saving treatments, ready before you ever need us. Your heart, our hands, connected. Sanford Heart.
I'm joined now by outstanding senior Augustana receiver, Isaac Jorgensen. Isaac, great to have you here. Folks have been used to watching you kind of rumble down the field and catch those passes as a tight end, and we'll come back to that here in a minute. But to begin with, Roosevelt High School, and after high school and a great career, and a career in which you didn't play receiver, you had to pick a school. Why Augustana?
Well, I got recruited by the local area schools, Augie, USD, NDSU, and it came down to the people, really. I mean, I felt really comfortable when I came on my visit, and once I heard about all the guys that committed, the people from Watertown and the Sioux Falls guys, I knew we were going to be pretty good. And I just felt at home here, so I came here.
Yeah, and we're glad you did. Talk about transforming yourself from defensive player to receiver.
Well, it was kind of strange. I'd never played my position that I'm playing now, a tight end. I was always a defensive end in high school and a basketball player, so I was not really made to play football. I didn't play mm-hmm. it my whole life, but mm-hmm. came here and with Coach Chambers and the strength staff, gained a lot of weight, and I guess just that redshirt freshman year was huge, just to get mm-hmm. a year of practice and learn the system of the offense.
Right, right. Well, you've been playing football a long time. What do you like about the game of football?
I love the camaraderie of the 11 guys on the field at the same time. It's a large team. It's literally a family here of guys. And I mean, it's always great to be able to just go after a guy and try to push him to the ground without any consequences.
Yep. Yeah.
Actually, positive consequences yeah. if you do. So.
yeah. Get a chance to rumble around out there
right.
and bang into people. That's great.
Yep.
Changing gears just a little bit. Your major, and I think we talked before we went on the air here, still a little undecided about what you want to do, but what might you do?
Oh, I'm an exercise science major. And if I go that route, I would like to be a strength conditioning coach at a college. And I would love to be able to work with teams and stay away from the personal training and more mm-hmm. stay in that team aspect. I like that, how people work together. And if I don't go that way, I'd like to be a firefighter. Something physical, high intensity, mm-hmm. just kind of intrigued me.
Yeah, so yeah. Well, you'd be a good one, I'm sure, if you decide to do that. Well, fifth year senior here, Isaac, coming down the stretch for football. Reflect a little bit on what it's been like to be a student and a football player at Augustana.
Well, at first it was hard getting used to the academics and balancing the schedule, but I mean, it's something that I would do over in a heartbeat. Mm-hmm. I mean, all the things you go through with the guys, the workouts, off season, passing classes together, studying, and building the relationships and the bonds that we have is just something I'll never forget and will be with me the rest of my life, for sure.
Well, we've enjoyed watching you. You're going to be very successful, we know. So got some football to play, Luck?
That's right.
Yeah, good luck, Isaac.
Thank you.
It's got that certain everything. The 2012 Jetta, that's the power of German engineering.
With 25 years of experience and an outstanding trio of dentists, Drs. Bertolf, Biok, and Swingdorf, along with their caring team at Sensational Smiles, are passionate about developing long-lasting relationships. Sensational Smiles will partner with you to keep your teeth clean for a lifetime. Also check out our cavity-free club for kids with Sammy, our mascot, at SensationalSmilesForYou.com. Call 332-4751 now for a sensational smile every day.
He's got the strength and is making it look easy.
Show renewed strength. Whether it's our physicians, therapists, or athletic trainers, Sanford offers the finest and most integrated orthopedic team and services around.
There's nothing he couldn't lift right now.
For the everyday competitor in all of us, Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Let's take a look at the Augustana sports calendar for this week. Friday, November 9th, volleyball on the road at Winona State. Saturday, November 10th, volleyball back on the road again at Upper Iowa University. Football is at Southwest Minnesota State for a 1 o'clock kickoff. Wrestling is at the Dakota Wesleyan Open in Mitchell. And basketball has their first regular season home games, a doubleheader at the Elman Center. The women tip off against Mount Marty at 6 o'clock, followed by the men against Jamestown College at 8. Wednesday, November 14th, basketball back home again. The Vikings taking on Dakota Wesleyan University, 6 o'clock, and the men taking on Black Hills State at 8 at the Elman Center. And remember, for radio coverage of Augustana football and men's basketball, you can hear the Vikings on KIKN FM 100.5 and worldwide at KIKN.com. And Augustana women's basketball can be heard on KXRB AM 1000 and worldwide at KXRB.com. And Augustana Athletics information, for everything you want to know about Viking athletics, go to our website, GoAuggie.com, where you can also get tickets at GoAuggie.com/tickets. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you at this same time next week for another edition of Augustana Sports Scene. So long, everybody.
You have been watching Augustana Sports Scene, a weekly review of Viking athletics at South Dakota's largest private college. Learn more about Augustana College in Sioux Falls at augie.edu.